Dad here from Dad and Dax Play Games, and we're doing something a little bit different. So this is going to be a single player world with what my suggestions are for some of the server settings, just to take away some of the grindiness. And this is going to be kind of a all-inclusive noob's guide on how to get through probably your first 10 levels or so. So what I've got is, these are my settings. This is what it defaults to. However, I put pretty much everything to medium, just for best FPS for recording. Ground clutter, I'm going to bring down a little bit. This is what really will kill your FPS if you're on an older machine. So I'm going to bring it down to about here. And I'll probably keep the textures high. So 1920 by 1080, full screen. Everything else is the same. The only other settings that I have changed are the all stay put and the you follow me. Those are the settings that I like to have for the two most used whistle commands that I used. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into host local. I'm going to pick the center. These are some of the mods that I use on my regular series. Difficulty level, I'm going to crank up to 5. By default, the highest you can go is difficulty 1 on here, but you can put in any number you want over here. So with default or difficulty level number 5, what this will mean is the lowest, the dinosaur increment, or the dinosaur level increment, will be in levels of 5. So it'll be 5, 10, 15, 20, all the way up to 150. What I'm going to change here is nighttime speed. I'm going to put down to 0.7. XP multiplier, I'm going to put at 6. Taming speed, 3. Harvest amount, 6. And I think that's about the only thing that I would recommend changing. So I'm going to make sure that I have the center picked, and then I'm going to play single player. It will create all of the config files. It will load up all of the game files and everything. It will get to a point where we'll say populating your arc. What this is doing right now is it is essentially, the map is loaded, it is preloading all of the spawned in dinosaurs. So now we are at the character creation screen. There's a whole bunch of character presets, both male and female. You can change skin color, all that stuff. For this purpose, I'm not big on really making my character, so I just use the default one, pop in my name, and I'm going to spawn on Tropical Island South, which is going to be down here in this bottom right-hand corner of the map. Another safe one to do would be Tropical Island North. It's a little bit smaller. Resources can be a little bit less. So I'm going to go down, create new survivor. Hopefully I'm not going to get mobbed by anything right when I spawn in, because I am locked into this little cutscene. You cannot move. I've had times where I spawn in and I immediately get chewed up by Dilos. So I'm going to look around, make sure nothing's around. There is a Ichthyosaurus in the water. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull up the inventory with the I key. These are some of just some skins and stuff that you can overlay onto, like a Parasauropolis saddle. You can put a hunter hat on, dino glasses skin. These are skins that you can put on saddles. This one is specifically for the Parasaur. Under craftables, the first two things at level 1 that you can craft are a stone pick and a torch. So what I'm doing is I'm just moving those down onto my hotbar. So as I collect resources, once I have the required stuff, I can know what I need to pick up, or I know when I can craft it. So right now I have enough thatch, wood, and stone that I can craft this. So I'm going to do so right off the bat. We have our first level. The first levels come fairly quickly with the settings, because we have 6 times XP boost. So at level 2, what I like to do is wait. And the first engrams are essentially blueprints on what to craft. So I'm going to do the stone hatchet and the stone spear. So now I can craft these. What I'm going to do is go into my inventory, bring this down, bring that out, switch to my stone pick, and I'm going to collect resources. Now, I also have my next level. So, level 3, I also like to bump up weight, because at this point, resource gathering is the primary focus. You're going to get encumbered. The little bit of extra weight really helps. Campfire is what I suggest next, and pants. So at this point, what I need to do is I need to go up here, smack this rock with my pick, get some flint. Now I should be able to make the stone hatchet. Once I make it, I'm going to bring it down into my inventory. I can make the torch, bring that down, put that down on 6. From here, what I need to do is go over to a couple of these bushes, get some fiber, get some berries. And what I'm doing is I'm just hitting the E key to gather from the bushes. We have our next level already. Like I said, these first levels burn through pretty quickly. So I'm level 3 going to level 4. Weight also. So the next thing I'm going to do is thatch foundation, thatch door frame, and thatch door, and finally thatch ceiling. This will get me my first structure. So I want to keep gathering from the bushes, and I'm going to go over and start collecting thatch from the trees. With the stone pickaxe, hitting this will give me more thatch than it will wood. If I use the axe, I will get more wood than thatch. So, next level, we are level 4 going to level 5. I want to bump up my movement speed a little bit and make the slingshot. That pretty much uses up everything that I have. I want to make a couple spears, because at this point I need to start killing some stuff to get some meat and some hides, because I want to make the slingshot that I just unlocked. So I'm going to take these first two spears that I made. What do I need to make some more spears? I need more flint, which means I need to go back over to one of these rocks, get a bunch of flint. Gotta make sure I do not accidentally hit that trike, because he would mess up my world. Now, wood. Hello, Mr. Dilo. Or Mrs. Dilo. So I'm gonna back away from this guy. I do not want to fight him yet. I want to get a few more spears, and then we're going to fight. I was hoping to find some dodos. Lystrosaur wouldn't be too bad to kill for some meat. I don't particularly like killing lystros. So, next level. And this is all notional at this point. Everything is exactly the same as what I would do with like default settings. However, it would take longer in between these levels. So I'm just getting rid of some of the stuff that I don't really need. And what I'm doing is I'm just hovering over and I'm hitting the O key. So go back into the inventory, and we have level 5 going to level 6. Once again, I want to move up movement speed. And level 6, I want to get the hide sleeping bag and the storage box. The hide sleeping bag will give me a respawn point, and the storage box will give me something to start storing my stuff in. So at this point, I want to make a small structure. So thatch foundation. I want to make 4 of these. I want to make 8 door frames. I want to make 8 doors. And I'm a little bit shy, probably on thatch. Maybe fiber, I'm not sure. Now, you can't move around very fast when you're crafting. You act almost like you're encumbered. I think that parasaur may be stuck on the tree. So I think we may relieve him of his meat and hides. There's that. So I may be low on wood. I'm over encumbered right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start building my structure right here. There. Now I'm going to select my door frames. Now most people would pick the walls at this point. However, I find that the door frames at early level, you craft a whole bunch of them, and with crafting the doors and the door frames, you get more experience than you get from just the walls. Not a whole lot more, but it does help. So I'm going to place these down. Place the doors in. And I have a level already. And then, so I'm one shy on the doors. I cannot make it yet. Let me see what I'm missing. Fiber. So I'm going to get my level next. So we're level 6 going to level 7. So I want to start bumping up my health. Mortar and pestle and spark powder. That is the next two things that I suggest doing. So we're going to see what we need for the mortar and pestle. I need 15 hides, which means I need to kill some stuff. Let me go see if this Parasauropolis is actually stuck on the tree. You'll notice that they get stuck every once in a while. They'll spawn and kind of clip into the tree. So you can kind of use that to your advantage. There we go. And now I want to use the pick. The pick will give you generally more, I believe it's hide than meat, but this is actually being, almost hit that trike. That would have been bad. It's very close to what it was giving me, which is usually not the case. So we have a bunch of meat now, and we are level 7 going to level 8, so I'm going to pick health next. And I want to learn the narcotic. This will help with some of our first tames. Now, to start spoiling out some of the meat, what I'm going to do is split the stacks. To be able to do that, you just hold down the left shift key and you separate it into a different stack. Now, if you notice, all of these will spoil in 9 minutes and 12 seconds. In this stack, only the top one will spoil in 9 minutes and 4 seconds, 3 seconds. So it just makes it so that way it spoils a little bit quicker. So at this point, I am fiber deficient. So I need to get some fiber to not only make the storage bin, because I want to start off loading some of this stuff. And then I got to get some stones. And then I gotta get more fiber to make some pants. Let's get some fiber, get some pants on. I think the sun might be starting to go down a little bit. And I want to make sure that I get some pants on, because that will help keep me a little bit warm. I'll make one more storage box. And that will give me my next level. So level 8 going to level 9. I want to increase wait some more. And from here, I want to get the walls, cloth shirt, and what's the last one? Cloth boots. So at this point, I can actually start replacing some of the doors with walls. And I'll show how that's done in just a second. So I'm going to go back over here. Oh, and I need to make 4 ceilings. What do I need for ceilings? Roof. I need wood and fiber. There's that. And this should get me close to my next level. There we go. So level 9 going to level 10. I want to increase weight once more. And I want to learn the water skin. Where's my water skin hiding? And where'd it go? Water skin, cloth gloves, cloth hat. And that will finish me out, and I will be able to make my full ensemble of clothing once I get enough fiber. Fiber. So from here, what I can do is I can put on my hat, and then since I have the hunter hat skin, I can put it on top of my hat, and now it looks like I'm wearing a leather hat. And if you go into K mode, you can look at yourself. However, you can't turn, so you don't want to do that accidentally when you're trying to run away from something. I can press T to select the entire stack of what's in there. Bring it down here. Place the roofs. There's that. Oh, and I need one more door. What am I missing for door? Fiber. So, shirt, boots, gloves. That should finish me off. That's a Dilo. I do not want to get hit by their spit. That would be bad. Basically what it does is it blinds you and you move very slowly. So, last door. Put my full ensemble on. So what I want to do is start replacing some of these walls. Let's craft these up. And I have another level. So back door. Main door. You always want to make sure that you have more than one exit point just so you can get in and out. So in case something chases me, I come in here, and then as it's chewing on this door, if need be, I can get out this side and get out. So the next thing that I am going to increase is my weight is at 150, movement speed is 104, so movement speed is next. And at this point, I want to learn the bed. Let me just look and make sure that I'm not forgetting anything. I'll upgrade to wood shortly, but I'm not quite ready for that yet. Okay, Bolo. This was the next thing that I wanted. And then bed will be probably next level. So I have 5 Engrams. Is there anything that I need to spend it on? It does not appear to be so at this point. So I'm going to save those. You don't have to spend your Engrams every level. Let me get back inside. I want to make the Bolo. I'm going to make 3 of these. Mortar and Pestle. Low on stone. So I'm going to go get some stone. Make the slingshot yet. I did not make the slingshot. So that's the next thing that I want to make is the slingshot. And I'll worry about that level in just a minute. I don't want to get distracted and forget what I'm doing. So I'm going to get the stone. I'm going to swap this out and get a bunch of flint. Because I also want to get some spark powder going. Now I have the materials in my inventory to repair my pick. So I can just hit the button and it will automatically repair it. So I want to get the rest of this as flint. It'll also give me a little bit of metal. I'm not really worried about the metal right now. That's kind of a mid-game thing. So there's that. The metal's just going to wind up going into a crate until I'm ready to use it. So now, this, and mortar and pestle. I know I have enough to make you now. Where are you hiding? Right there. Make one of those. And slingshot. What am I missing for the slingshot? I need fiber. Of course I need fiber. Always running low on fiber. So, let's go get some fiber. And like I said, I'll worry about this level up in just a moment. If I don't get what I'm doing right now, I will forget the slingshot, go to tame something, and be just completely out of luck because I'll have been distracted, forget to make it, and bad stuff will happen. So, slingshot. I'm actually going to make two of these. One for basically a respawn chest, which will be this third one. So you'll go in there, you'll get a little bit of that. So now I have ammo for there. We'll keep 30. You come down here. So I can use the bolos for trapping the legs of the animals, so that way they can't run away. And then I can knock them out with the slingshot. So you're still not quite done yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold down the left shift key, double click, it will move 5 over. If I were to double click, it would move 1 over. Same thing. If I hit T, it will move the entire stack over. If I hit shift T, it will move half the stack over. But I don't want to have that much in there. So I have my slingshot, I have my bolos. My axe is almost dead. I need more thatch. Do I have more thatch? I can get more thatch. I want to repair it now before I forget about it. Get all the thatch. Hit I for the inventory. With it selected, I can hit repair item. Bring it back down here. Can I make a few more spears? Short on fiber. Okay. 3 spears should be enough. What are you? Are you a Dilo? I think that's a Dilo. That wants. I want to get a Dilo for my first tame, just to have a little bit of a protector. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the narco berries, and where did I put my spoiled meat? I know I spoiled some meat. Where did I put it? Right here. So I have narco berries and spoiled meat. Narco berries, spoiled meat. Go to consumables, drugs, narcotics. I can make 6 narcotics. So what's more here? I can offload these berries. Let me offload the rest of this. That. And the next thing I can do is in here, stone and flint. Oh, did not mean to get out of that. I can make spark powder. Spark powder is good for the fuel for fires, for preserving bins. The downside is when you get to late game, it does not create charcoal, which charcoal is used for gunpowder. So let me see. I have 6 narcotics now. What am I missing for? I'm missing narco berries. So I want to take my narcotics. Let me figure out what I want to do for my next level. I'm at 120 health now. Movement speed is 106. I want to get my movement speed up. Ooh, I got 2 levels. So movement speed of 110 is a fairly good start. Simple bed is the next thing that I want. The only reason I really took the hide sleeping bag is because you need the hide sleeping bag to be able to learn the bed. Now at this point, I can make the bed, and stimulant I don't care about. What am I looking for? Where is it? Paraceropolis saddle would be nice. Let's see, what level? Not quite enough for the bow and the arrow yet. I think what I will do is get the Paraceropolis saddle. So what I'm going to do is uncheck this because things are getting a little bit hard to read. So hide, fiber, and wood. Let me see. You're done. Take you out. I have a little bit of charcoal, not much. Now, hide. I can go in here, see what I need. Hide, fiber. Of course, I'm running low on fiber. So let's go out here, see if we can find a Paraceropolis that is close by. If I'm riding on a Paraceropolis and I attack the bushes, it will collect some of the berries and stuff way faster than I can do. I was needing fiber, so I have enough fiber for that now. So I'm going to run back. I'm going to craft this up. So wood, hide, craft you up, put the rest of this stuff back because I don't need to wait. Got another level. Actually, I need the narco berries, spoiled meat. I'll be able to make, I think, one more. Yeah, one more. Now, on this, movement speed is good for a while. Weight 150 is decent. So I'm going to start pumping a little bit more into health. So I don't know exactly what I want to get yet. Probably standing torch. Spyglass wouldn't be bad. Cooking pot's not really going to be all that useful for me until I get to farming. I think what I'm going to do is start getting some of the wooden ones a little bit. Wooden walls. So what I'm going to do is get this narcotic, get the spark powder. Spark powder is going to be my fuel for the fire for the foreseeable future. We're going to come out here and I'm just going to show you how to knock this stuff out. Female Dilo would be nice, so I could get Dilo eggs. So basically all I'm doing is smacking it with rocks, preferably in the face. Headshots will knock it out quicker. It's got to be getting close to getting knocked out. There we go. Oh boy, we got a raptor. So I'm going to get the... normally you don't want to do this at low level, but I have the bolos, so I'm gonna try it. Come on, buddy. Why are you running away from me? Get the bolo out. There we go. Oh, and he's just a baby level. Or she's a baby level. Nice. There we go. knock you out. Ew, I need raw meat. Oh, I was gonna say, we got a second one over here. This could be bad. Let's knock you out. I'm just kind of bobbing and weaving just in case anything's sneaking up on me. Rocks. There we go. Knock you out. Actually, I'm going to split the stack there. Because you need some. So we have a level 10 female and a level 25 female. Now, while they're taming out, I need to collect more rocks. Just in case anything else attacks me. And it looks like my slingshot's getting a little bit damaged, so I need wood, fiber, and hide, which I do not have on me. So back at the base. So you seem to be doing good. Normally I would not suggest trying to tame out three things at once. Bad things can happen when you're doing this because any old thing can come along and kill them right now because they're defenseless. Is that a metal node? Okay, that's a metal node. I'll go back and show that in just a minute what to do with that. Let's kill you for some meat. Get a little bit of hide. Now, can I repair you? I need wood. Let's pop it back into the inventory. Hit repair. Bring it back down. And we'll be good to go. So you're about getting close to halfway. Let me see. I'm going to pop one narcotic into you just to raise your torpor a little bit. I don't want him waking up. Everything looks good. You're doing good. You took a lot of damage. So, next level. Next thing I want to do is, let's see. Melee damage I don't really care about right now. Movement speed's 110. Weight's 150. So, the next thing I want to do is pump up my health to 150. Oh, I can get a raptor saddle. Nice. Let's go see how my raptor buddies are doing. Doing good. You're going to take a little bit longer. Just because of the higher level. And like this one right here is a level 10. Based off of taming effectiveness of the raw meat that I'm using, she's only going to gain plus 4 levels. So she'll tame out right now, as long as the taming effectiveness does not drop any, she will tame out at a level 14. Every so many bites of food that they take, the taming effectiveness can drop a little bit. So she may only be like a level 12 or 13 when she finally tames out. This one is going to be level 25 plus 10 levels. Barring any reductions in taming effectiveness based off of how many times she eats. Okay, and our Dilophosaurus is awake. We're going to come over here, set you to follow. We are going to hold E to access the more options. Wow, you tamed out at a level 107. Nice. So change name, and Dilly is the Dilo name. So what I can do with these guys is smack it. She'll attack him. She'll kill him. Level 95 Lystro. That would take forever to tame. Because I do not have... Wow. Where'd the body go? What'd you do with the body? Let's get over here. And level 14. Nice. So... change your name. And we're gonna name you Jill. Just because. And then your sister over here is gonna be named Jane. Get those off you. Raptor saddle. I can make that. And then once the raptor saddle finishes crafting, I can put it on her. Gained another level already. And then I can ride her. So anything that she would attack on her own, I can now attack with her, and I will gain a portion of the experience from riding on her. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go when she's done pooping. That can be funny at times, but if you're in the middle of a fight and they stop doing that, that can be a little bit annoying. So we're gonna kill all the Dilos over here. Okay, so our stamina's already low. So that's gonna be something that we're gonna need to pump up. One more narcotic, just to make sure you stay under. You're almost done. So now next level is level 15. We're going up to, I think, level 16. So we should be able to make the bow and the arrow. And we have seven more engrams, which I want to make the wood ceiling. And then next one, I want to make the wood ramp. And then the wooden doorway, so that way I can make a taming pen. One more bite, I think, and Jane will be done. Jane, let's see what your stats are. 320 health, stamina's pretty decent, melee attack, and movement speed's 120. Movement speed is 120. So now, if you notice on my own movement speed, I've bumped it up to 110, which means I cannot outrun raptors yet. Basically, in the movement speed, what you eventually want to do is get it above 120, so that way, if you get cornered by raptors or Dilos or something like that, you can get away from them on foot if whatever mount you're on gets killed from underneath you. Because these guys run pretty fast, they got a nice little jumping attack. So that is going to be it for this episode of the Complete Noob's Guide for How to Not Die in Ark. Even though you probably will die, I'm actually surprised I have not died yet. So we're going to have them stay put. We're going to make sure that everybody is set to neutral, so that way they won't go off attacking stuff on their own. The keyboard command for that is the apostrophe. That will bring up the command for everybody that's around. So that's going to end it for the episode of basically how I play this game on a solo server. I'm Dad from Dad and Dax Play Games. Bye.